agree with me that the labor market is so saturated now and there are no jobs anywhere. This is where skill acquisition comes in and cannot be overemphasized. Today on Tripline on OGTV, the people's telly, we will be taking a trip to the BBHS art department. There will be taken through the process of photography, which is a skill if acquired can take care of the labor market. Do come and learn with us.
Welcome children, I'm Mr. Richard Michael Adini, and welcome to the BBHS Art School. Come along with me. Children, you are welcome again. This is the BBHS Mission Art School. You are welcome once again. And over here we have cotton painting, and you can see them, they are beautiful. Over here we have recycled boards, these are made from recycled materials. Over here we have photograph, and this is part of what we will be doing today. This is big format photograph. And over there too, you have some photograph. And these are some graphics work by the student. And there will be still some graphics work over there. These ones are called silhouettes. These are called silhouettes. And you can use black cardboard to make these ones. Do you understand that? So over here, you have another photograph here. These are not big format photographs. You can see the student matching. This is tiny mass pass. Over here we have some other photographs. And you know that today I will be taking you to photography. We will be learning photography on two planes today. So this is one of the photographs too that we'll be shooting today. Look at this. This is another photograph. And over here you have another photograph. And over here we have some artists as well. These are beautiful artworks produced in this studio. I hope you have seen what you have seen so far, students. Children, you have seen what you have seen so far, children.
Yeah.
Our conversation today is going to be photography. But before we go outside to take photography, I have to tell you some things about camera and the laptop over there. Let's come this way. So to take good photograph, you need a good camera. So I would like to tell you certain things about this camera. This is a digital camera. In those days, we used analog camera. The difference between this is just that one, you need a film to snap. You have a photographer will buy a film before snapping. But this one, these days now, you don't need a film. This is a digital camera, and you are in digital world. Do you know that? So now, you can take picture with this. This is a camera, and when you want to take a picture, you have to consider certain things. You have to put on your camera first. And this is where you set what you want to do. Like now, it is in auto. In the auto side, you can actually take picture without a flash. But you need a flash as regards this digital camera. You put up the flash there. And this one goes up. Now, when any picture you take, it will automatically give a shot. That is when you are taking picture indoors. When you are taking indoor pictures, you need a flash. Do you understand that?
Yes.
You need a flash to take pictures inside. But when you are taking pictures outside, you don't need a flash. So that means you close it. You understand that? You close it. And then another thing you have to consider that when you put on the camera, what happens? The zoom, this is your zoom. The zoom lens will come out. That means you are ready to take photographs. Do you understand that? And you have two ways of seeing what you are snapping. You either use this big side or you use the field finder. This is the field finder, or you use the screen. Either of the two. You use this screen or you use this field finder. How you go back to the field finder is by pressing here. When you press this side, let me do it and you see. You can't see anything again. That means it has turned over to this field finder. And when field finder, you have to do like this. That's why you see some photographer when they want to take picture, they have to see like this. That means for you to see what you want to take, you have to do the field finder. But if you don't want to take good, go through that space. What you just need is just use the screen. Easily you can see whatever you want to take. You understand that? So that is about the camera. And when you are taking your pictures, whether you take it indoor or outdoor, you need a laptop to see better what you are doing. what you have done. Especially if you want to edit, there are a lot of software you can use to edit. That is one of them is Photoshop and we have the Microsoft Picture Manager. So what you do is just like this, and you need a USB cable. This is a USB cable. You connect this, with this device, you can connect your camera to your laptop so that you can access what you have snapped. Do you understand that? So when you do, you have to look at the where the USB cable can go in there. So when you use the USB port, you put it inside. So the USB port, you put it inside this way. Do you understand that? So before you now connect to your camera. So to connect to your camera, look at this side, you have to find where the USB port is. So this is the one for the camera. You put it on like this. Do you know what you have done that way? You have connected this camera with the laptop so that you can access this camera. Do you understand that? Yes. For you to access what you have on this camera, you have to use a USB cable to connect it to your camera. And when this is done, you can actually access your picture from the camera on this system where you do a lot of editing. You can use, I have told you that you can use different software. One of them is Photoshop and Photo Picture Manager, Microsoft Picture Manager. Those are one of the software you use. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So when that is done, that is when you go ahead and copy. But before we go to that, I would like us to go outside and take some pictures so that we can come in again and see what you are taking and copy it into a flash drive. Copy into a flash drive, that is when you can go to a lab and print. But before we do that, the first thing we are going to do right now is to go out there and take some pictures. So come along with me. So children, this is a camera as I said earlier on. So to take a picture, you have to remove this and before you put it on. But even without this, you can still take your picture. Do you know that you can use your mobile phone to take pictures? Do you know that? So you can use the mobile phone. This is my mobile phone. I can use this to take beautiful pictures, and you can even use your mom's phone as well. You can use daddy's phone. You can just borrow it for a while and use it to take good pictures. Do you understand that? So now you just to use the mobile phone, you just have to go to the camera. You access the camera and from there you take beautiful pictures. And whether you are using the mobile phone or you are using a camera, a professional camera, what is matter is that when you are taking outdoor pictures like this, you don't face the sun. You don't face the sun, because if you do that, it will destroy your picture. So to do that, to take a good shot, you have to back the sun. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So you can see that the direction of the sun this afternoon is this way. So to take a picture, what do? You have to back the sun and take your model has to be this way. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So of this you can use your mobile. You know, we are talking about skill acquisition on this. That is the emphasis of this program, Swift Learn on OGTV. So you can use your mobile picture and take good pictures and even take it to a printer and print it out. But to do that, just like I have told you earlier on, that you connect your camera to the system. But right now you can connect your mobile phone too. If you have a USB cable, what you just do is that you just connect it from here. Do you understand that? You just have to look for the USB cable case. Or better still, you can just remove the back of your phone and remove the memory card. When you remove the memory card, you insert into it what we call memory card reader. Or there are some laptops that can access your memory card directly. Do you understand that? So when you do that, when you connect it into your system, you can now go ahead and edit it with your Photoshop or Microsoft Picture Manager. Do you understand that? So to take good pictures, you have to consider those factors that you don't face the sun. You don't do what?
Yes.
Especially when it's going to be outdoor picture. And to take an outdoor picture, you don't need a flash. I hope you've not forgotten that. You don't need a flash. What you just need is just to take your picture. And you just have to consider a good point weather. But meanwhile, in the evening, when it is in the evening, you have to use your flash. Do you understand that? In the evening when you are taking pictures, to have a good shot, you have to use your flash. But in the afternoon this way, you don't need a flash. All you just use is like, you just bat the sun and you take your picture. So right now we are going to do some, we are going to take some pictures. So we have you to post on. Now we are batting the sun. I hope you know that. So you go that way. It's okay. You want to go further than that. Don't forget, the first thing to do when you are holding your camera, what do you do?
You on it.
Can somebody just press on? So when you on it, you see your zoom lens will come out. This is the zoom lens. It will come out. It will do what?
It
will come out. Alright boys, let's try it again. Somebody should just press the on button. And you can see that the zoom lens will come out as you do that. Let's try it off again. Can you do that again? Once more. You can see that the zoom lens will come out as soon as you put on the camera. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So now you can now take your picture. So to take your picture, I'm going to ask our gentleman here to do that for us. So hold the camera this way and hold it this way as well. So your shutter, do you know who can tell me where the shutter is?
Yeah, okay.
This is the shutter. So what you just do to take a picture, after you must have focused on your object or your model. Your object or your model. What you just do next. And again, when you are taking pictures, don't allow your hand to shake. That is why sometimes you need a tripod to do that. But meanwhile, you can see all this family in such a way that it doesn't shake. Because when that happens, the picture will not be so sharp and bright enough. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
So when you now what to do is that you have to hold your camera firmly. You hold it firmly and you make sure that you just with just a tip of your finger, you just press the shutter. Can you do that now? Can you just press the shutter? This is the shutter, yeah? Can you just press it? Yeah, we focus at our model there, yeah? Press it. You press it well. Press it down. Yes. When you hear, that means you are taking a picture. Look at what you have just done there. You are just taking a picture. And do you know one thing? We are backing the sun. And that is where we can have a sharp object shot here. Do you understand that? So I would like someone else to try it again. Okay, now right now what we are going to do is that we are going to ask Auntie Queen, the producer of this program, Tripling on OGTV, to pose for us and we are going to give her some nice shots. So Auntie Queen, can we have you as our model? You come this way, I will tell you what to do, ma. So you are going to be our model right now. So we are going to give you some instructions. So when we ask you to change your posture, you change your posture. If your model is too far away from you, what you do is just to zoom the person closer to you. Do you understand that? So you press the shutter. Yeah, press it. Let me see. And Chris, can you change your posture? Okay, do it again. Press it again. Can you do that again for us? Another side, ma. Now we want to have a posture of mother and child. So look at the way they are posed. So I want that feeling because you can also have your picture as an artist. So you don't have to contract an artist to do your painting of the child. So let's assume this is your child. And hold him gently, tenderly, as if he's your child. So what we are going to do now, we are going to give them some nice shots. Modern side graphics. Okay, we are going to have a close shot. Okay, we can have another post shot. Let's have another post shot. Okay.
Can you
just be happy? I think you are watching your mom. Just smile. Just as if look at the camera as well. Just as if you've been away from home for a long time and mommy has just come to visit you. Yes. Can we look at mommy's side? Mommy, look at your mom's side. Oh, that is nice. Can you do that again? Yes. I would like you to pose with the cameraman of this program. Come over again and let's take our cameraman alone. Let's take our cameraman alone. Look at some passerby over there. It's a dad and his son and the principal. Let them just take that shot.
Let's just take that woman. You can see that you can take motion now. Even when they are talking, you can still take pictures. That is a way of documenting moments. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
That is a way of doing what? Documenting moments.
So we'll be going back inside to show you the picture we are taking so far. Do you understand that?
So children, you are welcome back. Now, the next stage for you, after taking your beautiful pictures, after documenting that event, whatever event, with your camera, the next thing to do is to come here and use your USB cable. USB is Universal Carrier Bus. Universal Carrier Bus. Can you say it?
Universal Carrier Bus.
That is what USB is. And this is the cable. This is the USB cable. And on your laptop, you have the USB port. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So you look at it here and you connect it. So when you connect that, you now go on onto your camera. The port for your camera is this way. So you now insert it. Is that taking?
Yes, sir.
So when that is done, you now put it on. You have to put on the camera before you can access it on your laptop. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So pick anything on your laptop, you have to look for icon for the camera on your system. So this is the icon for this camera on your system. This is the icon. And to click anything, to pick anything there, you have to double click. You have to know that. So here you double click on it, it will bring it out. Do you understand that? So this is it. Yeah, and you should go to the DCIM file here. Yeah. So when you go there, you go to the last file to access the last picture we have taken. So you double click, to click anything on the laptop, don't forget to double click. So when you double click, you have your pictures. So is the laptop is accessing your camera just now. So what you wait until it is ready. Now it is ready. You have two ways of viewing what you have done. The first way is you make this one extra large. You click on the extra large button and you look for your picture before you now double click on the picture. Is that taken? So let's see the picture, beautiful picture we have taken with the auntie. Okay, so this is the auntie there, and you can see edit this picture. Let me just zoom out auntie. Look at the auntie. Yeah, on a good. So today, can you see?
Yes, uncle.
You can you see auntie?
Yes.
So this is the picture of the auntie we take, and you know that we take several ones. When you finish doing that, you just copy it into a flash drive. Your flash drive is one of the storage device that you use to copy your picture from the laptop. When you copy this on your flash drive, you can now take this to the studio to print. Do you understand that?
Yes.
When you copy to this USB to this flash drive, what do? You take it to the studio for printing. So when you do that, you just copy, you just insert it somewhere else again. You look for another USB port and you copy. So when you copy like this, and you can just send it to your laptop. Is that taking? After copying, what you do is to remove it and off your camera. The first one off, it's off that way, and we take it to a studio for printing.
Okay, as I told you earlier, you can have a soft copy of your picture on this device. What do you like about this?
Yes,
flash drive. So this is what you take to the studio for printing.
So when you come back from the laboratory for printing, this is an example of the hard copy you have. Look at a mother and a child there. It's not just little baby like this you can cuddle. You can see the way the auntie cuddle this boy the other time. You can see the boy, the auntie cuddle him the other time. and this is mother and a child. Over here you have a mother and his and her son too. This is a good picture. Do you understand that? This is another good picture. And over here, the fourth one here, you have two jolly friends. They are chatting, and somebody took this picture. They are not aware of them taken by the cameraman. But look at what the photographer have done. Capture that essence. So over there too, you have samples, series of samples of these 5x7 pictures. These are 5x7 pictures, and you can also do more. Not just 5x7 pictures. You can also do more. You can also paint big format pictures. Can you have this one for me? So these are some of the big format pictures. You will be so amazed that you can have your picture on a big format like this. Let me just show you. Look at this. You can have your picture printed this way too. And this one is called flex. Do you understand that? What do I call it?
Flex.
This is a flex painting, big format painting, in such a way that you can have a family picture like this too. You can have a family picture like this. And this is a man and his wife and their mom. You can see this is like a family can have a picture like that. You can have a picture of the father, mother, and the children. So I hope by the time you get home, go home and tell mommy to take a family picture. You can do that with your digital camera or even your mobile phone. I hope you know that.
Yes.
So over there, we have some other pictures that have already been framed. Apart from having it this way, after you must have printed it this way, you can now have it framed this way too. You can have it framed this way. And this way you can appreciate it better. At your birthday party, you can even take pictures. Meanwhile, before we end up today's program, I would like to know what you have learned so far.
I have learned that I can earn a living through photography.
I have learned that it is vital to acquire skills no matter the level of education.
I am so delighted by what you have learned so far. I hope you can learn more from a photographer somewhere. During your long break, you can go to a photographer and learn more of this trade. You understand that? And I believe that most of you will still be going to the university. Even while in the university, you can make a living through photography. And a lot of you know there is no job there. A lot of graduates out there with no job. When they get out of the university, they couldn't find a job. But with this skill you have acquired today, and I believe you are still going to sharpen that skill later by going to a photographer out there. So when you have this skill, you can earn a living through this. You have to know that there is no job anywhere. Do you understand that? And I believe you, as a young man, tomorrow you can earn so much through photography. Please, what you have learned today, don't play with it. Hold it. Practice more, because practice makes perfect. When you practice more on photography, get a camera, even a mobile phone, you can use it to practice more. And with this skill, this one can take you off the labor market. Thank you very much. And I do believe you will not take it just as an hobby. I'm happy to have you guys in my studio. Do you enjoy this session?
Yes.
Are you going to start taking photographs now?
Yes.
Thank you very much for coming.
Friends, let's appreciate my position.
Thank you once again for coming. Bye.
Bye.
Hope you enjoyed this week's edition of Tripling and also find this quite educative. Like I said earlier on, the issue of skill acquisition cannot be overemphasized. You are never too young or too old to acquire a skill. So please, acquire a skill today and contribute a quota to our national development. Until we come your way again same time next week for yet another edition of Tripling. On OGTV, the people's telly.
Goodbye and God bless.
Thank you.